Welcome to a short video presentation on how to use NetEdit for NetSim SUMO interfaced VANETs. Let us look briefly at the VANETs module in NetSim. VANET stands for Vehicular Adhoc Network and is a subset of Mobile Adhoc Network. It is a special wireless mobile network, in which high-speed mobile vehicles connect and communicate with one another despite frequent changes in the network topology. However, VANETs provides only a short range of connectivity for V2V and V2I communication. In NetSim, you can visualize roads, vehicles, roadside units, RSU, and connectivity between those vehicles on an ad hoc basis. NetSim VANETs comes with an inbuilt interfacing with SUMO. SUMO, Simulation for Urban Mobility, is an open-source continuous traffic simulator designed to handle large road networks. The road traffic simulation is done by SUMO, while NetSim does the network simulation along with RF propagation modeling in the physical layer. The links is an ad hoc multipoint-to-multipoint link that connects all devices. It serves as a common link for all the vehicles and roadside units. Creating a SUMO network configuration file using NetEdit. NetEdit is a graphical network editor for SUMO, in which we create and modify the SUMO networks, which includes lanes, vehicles, signals, etc. It can be used to create networks from scratch, and to modify all aspects of existing networks. The input formats that we give to NetEdit network editor include sumo.net files, OSM files, and netconvert configuration files. The output format that we receive are sumo.net files or plain XML files. We will now see how to create a new road network, with a few vehicles, signals, one-way or two-way lanes. Note, that SUMO network can be created either manually or using SUMO NetEdit. To open NetEdit, go to the installation directory, where SUMO is installed. Open the SUMO folder, and inside its binary folder, you will find the netedit.exe application that you must run. Run the application in admin mode. Using this utility, users can quickly design road networks and obtain network.net.xml file, which is part of SUMO configuration. Go to the File menu and click on New Network. You can also use the shortcut, Ctrl+N, to perform the same. Choose the mode for creating junctions and edges, or you can also press E, which is the shortcut. Enable the grid, chain, and two-way checkboxes. Grid option gives you the grid view environment, and restricts the movement to the grid. Chain option is used to create consecutive edges with a single click. Two-way option automatically creates an edge in the opposite direction. Deselect this for one-way lanes. Initially, the design area will be small. You can use mouse scroll to zoom out or zoom in to adjust the design area before getting started. Ensure that the road network lies in the positive XY quadrant, to avoid complexities while opening the same network scenario in NetSim's grid view. Click on the grid area, an edge is generated. Click on another point, new edge will automatically connect to it, since we have enabled the chain option previously. Press T or select the mode to edit traffic lights over the junctions. The Edit Traffic Light table opens in the left-hand side. Click on the edge or connecting edges where you want the traffic signals to be present, and click on Create TLS button. Save the network. It will be saved with extension.net.xml. You can create a separate folder, and save the network file in it. Press C or select the mode for editing connections between lanes. Edit Connections window appears in the left. Different options like dead ends, starts, conflicts, passing can be set. The key options to use for conflicting as well as passing edges is indicated here. You can also find different color combinations for source, target, possible targets, pass, and conflict. Save your final road network and close the window. Open command prompt from the working directory, in which the network file is present. Go back to the SUMO installation directory, and locate the tools folder. You will find different Python utilities from which we use randomtrips.py, to create the trips file along with the associated files, using the command. Once the trips file is generated successfully, the next step is to generate a SUMO configuration file. Sample SUMO configuration files can also be found in NetSim install directory as part of featured examples. To this format, we include one additional parameter step length, and specify the value in seconds. Now open the saved SUMO configuration file using sumo.gui.exe located in the binary folder of SUMO. Running VANETs in NetSim using the newly created SUMO configuration file. To open the scenario in NetSim, select VANETs from home screen. It will ask you for the SUMO configuration file path. Locate the path where you have saved the file. The road network created in SUMO will be automatically replicated in NetSim's GUI, and parallelly starts the SUMO simulation. Here, SUMO window can be used to visualize the flow of vehicles as per the road traffic conditions like vehicles moving, pause at signals, etc. While NetSim can be used to understand the V2V and V2I communication between the moving mobile vehicle or nodes. Users can observe that roads and vehicles from SUMO are automatically imported into NetSim. One can also notice an inversion of view in the GUI, since origin in SUMO is at the bottom left, while origin is at the top left in NetSim. Ensure that all the entities are connected together, and set the basic safety message application before we run the simulation. Specify both the source, as well as destination. Application flow will be indicated as shown here. Play and record animation option, allows users to view NetSim animation and SUMO animation in parallel. Equivalent movements of vehicles in SUMO, and NetSim can be observed. After completion of the simulation, you will get the results dashboard, consisting of performance metrics, protocol metrics, battery model metrics, etc. Thank you for watching this video. You may write to us at sales@tetcos.com for further information.